Hey everybody, welcome to the channel. It's me, your host, Andrew Salazar. Today we're going to continue our little project, little art project here. I went to Tokyo, went to Japan, took some photographs, used those photographs to do some drawings. So this was the ink drawing. I think we did this last week we did the color. So we did the color and now we're going to ink on top of it. Here's some other ones I'm working on. That one, here's one that I'm working on too. Okay, so we're going to basically do something similar to this. We're gonna just do a layer of inks on top of the watercolors. I used a light box to go from this to this. So here we go, let's do this. And I just freehand drew it and inked it originally from some photography that I took. Okay, so here we go. Hopefully this, you can see this right. And we're just gonna go to town here. Now, the actual things I'm gonna use, I'm actually gonna go kind of lo-fi. I'm going to use this Rolling Writer Pentel, and I'm gonna use the Pilot Parallel Pen. I'm gonna use this morning thing. And I'm not going to use the photography for reference. I'm actually just going to use my inks. So I'm going to use the inks, which are kind of loose, a little sketchy. I'm going to kind of go for a sketchy flavor on this. And the idea really is just to just load up this drawing with the blacks. I think it looks cool like this, but I'm hoping that once the blacks come in, it's going to just like, ba-dow. So let's go, shall we? Here we go. Let's do it. And there might be some parts where I'm just gonna like I'm not gonna do as much detail in these, so we'll see. So let's just, and we keep the pencils, so that's fine. And I'm using this really as just as kind of a tech pen. I'm not even really using the parallel feature quite much. I might do it right there though, just for fun. These shrines and temples are hard to do because the way the architecture is, there's these little like elements to it, which is hard to like capture. It's hard to really describe until you see them. There's these things that are jut out of the building. And it's hard to say. See, I like all this looseness here. I'm gonna see if I can add some of that to this. Feel like I might actually use my Pentel because I can get a little bit thinner line on it, so we might try that in a sec. Going to these spiritual places was probably some of the most fun I had there. I mean, of course, I love going to the comic shops and like seeing all that stuff, but going to going to these like places was really cool for me. I'm gonna switch. See what happens here. I don't think I need this. I'll put this in the back here. Let's see what kind of a line I can get out of this. Yeah, I mean the line's pretty much the same. It's not really changing a whole hell lot, to be honest. That's a little smoother than this. This has got a little more scratchiness to it. I actually wish it was a little thinner. Darn it, I wonder if I should try to get another pen. Okay, one second. Let me grab one more pen and see if I can get a little bit better. Okay, the next pen we're gonna try is the Pentel Stylus. Now this has actually a, maybe part of it's take off my glasses. This actually has a bit of a flex nib on it. And I feel like, yeah, this might be a little bit better. I don't know. I'm not really feeling like it's different. Maybe it is a little bit. Okay. Now the question is, do I want to put all the hatching here? And I think the answer is going to be no. I'm not going to do the hatching. I think that's the right call, but I reserve the right to change my mind. Are these little like rings? This has got these little. Some stuff. I'm gonna be going back and forth between all these. Hopefully my head's not in the way. Sometimes I get down in this, and so my head kind of pops out. Does that look cool? It's kind of fun, right? It's kind of fun. try that with this guy. Yeah, he can go a little bit thinner, so I might want to use that. Okay. I'm doing these pieces not only for the fun of it, but also I have a gallery show in like a couple months, 2 months. And so I'm working on a lot of art for it, and I'm hoping to sell some. And most of it is more abstract and you know, landscape, stuff like that. But I'm also doing some illustration stuff too, so it's part of the reasoning behind doing these, is to maybe sell a few. We'll see. I might not sell any. You never know. Here's the thing about selling art. Just don't plan on it. You'll be happy. If it happens, great. If it doesn't, it's okay. Because, let me tell you, the problem with this is not very dark, so I do feel like it, like the darker one is this, which I like a little bit better, and the line quality is a little bit nice. It's just a little bit like a little more scratchy is what I like. Let's kind of play around with these, all these different ones. And this one might be the worst quality of them all, but I don't know, for some reason I like the way it writes. We'll do the trees. We'll do just a little bit of the trees. I don't want to put too much lines on these. and the colors themselves can differentiate, but that'd be kind of fun for just a little bit here. Actually, we'll put a little bit of this. There we go. Okay. Actually, kind of like that. Let's go back and finish this. Let's go back and finish this little shrine. How long is this video? We're 11 minutes? Okay, I don't want to spend all, you guys get bored. We'll do a little bit more and then we'll cut it. Unless you want to see me here for an hour just drawing away. Try to be efficient, respectful of time. I'm a big nerd on time. Time's a big nerd on that. I'll just do kind of broken lines for some of this stuff. See how that looks. think I got this thing so low, I'm like hunched over like a freaking character in a French story. Okay. That try for a sec, we'll go back to this bottom layer, actually same thing. There are these pieces of orange painted wood. Well, sometimes they're orange, sometimes they're just dark wood, but that are very bright, and they just stick out. It's kind of hard to render these things. I don't know if they read really well, to be honest. But I think in theory you get the gist of what this is. Be careful, you got some wet ink here, dude. Okay. I think it works. I think it registers somewhat. I actually dig it. I'm digging it. Oh, wrong lid. Okay. I'm digging it. I'm loving it. Okay. Yes. Yes. Okay. Yeah, I think that works pretty much. Can you put some of these little squares here? I drew these a lot in Japan. I was like, and it was just hard to get it figured out because it's super ornate. But I did like doing it. Okay, I think about going back all the time. I really would like to, but I would need a lot of subscribers to do that again anytime soon. But do it that way. But if you tell 100 of your friends, and those 100 tell 100 of their friends, maybe. Okay, I don't know if I like that, but that's okay. Let's move over to over here for a sec. Has my head been in this whole freaking thing? I hope not. So annoying. Oh, don't the colors of this look really nice? The colors turned out really good on this. And I think actually doing it this way with kind of the broken line works too. It kind of just gives it a little more homesy. I don't know what the right term is, but it kind of works, I think. Whereas before I was doing really like much more. It was definitely gestural, but it's very solid lines. I think this works a little bit better without the solid lines. So I think my first one, the one I did in Golden Guy, it might not be as good as this one actually now. But I've done this a couple times. Golden Guy is a place in Tokyo by Shinjuku, which is kind of a famous spot that people go to. It's got a bunch of, it's known as a couple of alleys. It's kind of a couple alleys that have a lot of bars and pubs and things. And I went there, I think I went there twice. I didn't go in any. One, I don't drink. And two, My Japanese was very limited and conversational at best. I mean, very little. So I just didn't like. Didn't want to do that. I did go into a maid bar once in Kyoto for just a few minutes, and that was a trip just to kind of like see what the culture of that was like. It was very fascinating to see how that culture, how that like whole gimmick is run. It's very fun. It's very playful. It's like this kind of fun, playful, almost childlike deal. But it was cool. It was kind of cool. I thought, dude, I'm in Japan. I gotta go to a maid bar. I gotta see what's up. And I did. That's cool. Okay. See how much darker this one is? I feel it's very much darker, but. Uses for the top layer. Cool, we're getting there. Okay, sorry about that, guys. My phone ran out of storage, so I don't know where we got cut off, but we got cut off somewhere. I think we're gonna end it here. This was kind of fun. I enjoyed it at least. It's not done, but it's getting there. And just share with you a little more process. Maybe I'll do another video of some more stuff. I try to do one video a week on like art stuff, and then we'll do the other videos on book reviews and adventures and things like that. So thank you for watching. Check out my new website. I got a new website. I'm excited about it. AndresSalzerArt.com. AndresSalzerArt.com. Very cool. Thanks for watching. Bye, guys. I'm gonna go get some food.